Across Alaska, there's almost 300 Native American villages at imminent risk due to climate change. Now, when I say imminent risk, I'm not quoting Greenpeace or the Sierra Club. I'm quoting the U.S. Army Corps of Engineers, not exactly a reactionary environmental group. Why are so many of these Native American villages at risk? It's because they've built their towns and their villages often along the coast that provides the best access to hunting and fishing. But as our permafrost crumbles and melts, and as the autumn sea ice comes later and later in the year, we see that storms that used to crash harmlessly on the sea ice miles out from the town, those storms are now crashing on the land instead. And they're not crashing on solid frozen ground, they're crashing on ground that has been melting and crumbling. And so whenever that autumn storm comes, it rips away feet, even yards of coastline, leaving many of these villages hanging off the edge of a cliff and often crumbling right into the ocean. Those villages would like to move, but they don't have the resources to. Who's going to pay them hundreds of millions of dollars to pick up all of their structures or rebuild them somewhere new? I worked with one of these villages. I worked with the town of Kivalina. Kivalina is located on a little spit of land sticking out into the ocean. That spit of land used to be safe ground for them. But now, as the Arctic warms, we're seeing that the ground under their feet is literally crumbling, washing away their homes and their buildings. We're seeing that their way of life, which include digging holes in the frozen ground to store the animals that they catch, their way of life is disappearing because as the ground melts, it can no longer serve as a freezer. And it's hard to get a freezer that fits a whole whale or a walrus in it. So Kivalina wants to move, but who's going to help them do it? That's the question we're faced with today.